Good afternoon, and we're in Lewisburg, Pennsylvania, and we're at Bucknell University. We're going to learn how to square up a frame for a 3D printer called a VzBoT. Make sure your frame is squared. Once you do that, you'll save yourself a multitude of problems in the future. If your frame is crooked, your prints are going to be crooked. If your frame is skewered, your prints are going to be skewered and get spaghetti. It only takes a few minutes. People struggle for a long time trying to get the beds level when all you really need to do is make sure your whole frame is squared. Once it's squared, you're good to go. So spend that extra few minutes in the beginning of the build of your printer to get it all squared up. With a few easy steps, I'm going to show you how to get your frame all leveled up. Okay, let's start. I'm going to count four rods out. These are the 460s, four of those, four 530s, and four 2040 extrusions. One, two, three, four of these, and 12 screws. All right, we're going to make sure these rods are totally even by taking two rods and making sure that one is longer than the other so we have a good square. Okay, so I'm going to use my contact lens case and some Loctite. I'm going to put it in here and put a couple of drops in here because it doesn't evaporate so quickly and I don't use too much. Then I get my M525 screw. I dip the tip over here. And then I put it on the side. The flat side should go facing the 460 extrusion. Also, make sure that you have the blind joints facing towards you so the screws will go through, or else I'll get blocked. That's the wider hole. Then the next extrusion, which is going to be the longer one, you face pointing up like this. Just tighten it. You don't want to squeeze this super tight because you're going to do some adjustments later on. So that's good for now. I'm going to make sure that it's kind of square. I'm using this machine is square. This is super squared up square. Super square. All right, so you check all sides to make sure you don't have any gaps. And you can tighten up a little bit. In a little bit, I'm going to use a flatter surface. But for now, this should be okay. And yeah, that looks good. And I need to make one tiny adjustment over here, so I'm going to tap it so it comes back out so it's even. Just a little tap. It's best not to use the extrusion. You should use something that, you know, you don't care about. But yeah, so now I'm making it tighter, so I think that's pretty square. Using a drill. Not a drill, but a screw, electric screwdriver. Okay. So now I'm going to get my bed plate, which is super flat, and I'm going to make sure everything is totally square, 100% squared. Tapping everything down so nothing is twisted. There's no twists or turns. One more final check on both sides. And then that's good. All right, so I'm going to start the next one here. And so I've done one corner with three rods. I'm going to do the same thing right now for the opposite side of the frame. All right, so remember, put your screws in the blind joint. So I'm going to do it by hand this time. I kind of like to use electric screw for the finishing, and the starting I like to use the hand, you know, screwdriver, the nut driver, because I can feel it better and I won't strip anything out. So that's pretty, you know, sure bet that's not going to happen because my fingers get, you know, are not that strong. Like, whoa. All right, so you can see that straightening out right there. So it's kind of a nice, loose, tight fit. And, you know, I'm going to square this up too in a second. Let me put a blind joint out facing you. Get a screw, dip it in the juice, put it in the screwdriver or nut driver, and dip it one more time. Just a tip. Just tip in slowly. And figure out how it goes in like this. Okay. Yeah, it's a little awkward. I was trying to find a better way of doing it, you know, and showing you guys. It's probably best if I leave it on the edge of the table, you know, and do it. Yeah, so I'm making sure this is totally flat as possible on this metal plate. Once again, here comes my machinist square tool. checking every corner, banging everything down flat, looking good. You're never going to get 100% total flatness. It's going to be a little bit of deviation unless you have, like, you know, perfectly cut, you know, rods. So I'm just trying to adjust these over here to make sure it's going to be as square as possible as I can get it, you know. Unless they're laser cut, you know, it's going to be hard. But, you know, you got to deal with what you got. Remember, this is a used beat up Tronxy printer I got for $100. All right, so let's not go crazy over here. All right, so here comes the fun part. Let's put all these six pieces together and make sure the whole frame is squared up. All right, so I'm getting all my things together here, getting ready. This is going to be exciting now. You ready, boys and girls? All right, the first thing I've been doing is I've been calling the extrusions 2030s, but they're actually 2040s, so that's my correction right there. The wider ones are 2040s, okay? So 2040s always have to face the flat side towards the 460s, the shorter pieces, okay? So now I'm noticing there's something wrong over here, and guess what? I made a huge boo-boo. I'm making the flat side face the long piece, so I have to switch that around. So all that squaring up I just did, I spent about like 5 minutes doing that. You know, I didn't shoot that much because I edited some of this, but yeah, I spent about 4 minutes just getting these corners totally perfectly straight. So now I have to undo all that. All right, so make sure you know which way your 2040s are facing. They should all face in the same direction. So now I'm gonna show you the trick and how I fix them, okay? Ready? All right, so I just took one screw out and I'm gonna twist it the other way, see? Watch. It was like this, right? And then I just turn the piece and then I make it fit now. All I had to do was turn it and make it fit. And then put the screw in. So I made it face the opposite direction. So now I'm putting the screw from the bottom up. And a different side can see a little better over here. All right, so now you can see which way it goes. Whatever piece you did, the first three pieces, it has to be the opposite. And always make sure, again, that those 2040s are facing all in the same direction. And that was my first mistake over here. So don't fall for that one. Okay. So now the piece is facing the right way. The short piece is right there. Everything lines up perfectly. Okay. Yeah, so the frame is not really that hard. It's just, you know, spending the time to try and get everything squared up. So it's not that tricky, but, you know, hopefully, you know, this won't happen to you. And I hope I'll save you like a few minutes over here so you know what to look out for. All right, so now I'm getting ready to put all these corners together. So again, a little bit of Loctite to the blind joint, and I'm gonna stick this 2040 extrusion on top and see if I can turn it with my thumbs and just to get a little start on it. Okay, once I get a little start on that, you know, I'm gonna get my other one and put it on the other hole so it's not gonna flop around too much. Now, my cat likes to help sometimes. You know, she likes to inspect things. So I'll let her inspect while I kind of built over here. She knows what she's doing. So, all right. So let me put the final touches on this over here. Tighten it up. Now, I got boxes and boxes of screws, right? But notice what I have in my hand right now and what I'm using. I was using a hex bolt before. Now I'm using a Phillips bolt. I didn't have any. I was short like four screws. So I had to wait 2 days, and that's why everything is delayed. I wanted to have this video done like 2 days ago, but I had to find these screws. And in New York, it's hard to find because everybody's Imperial. The only two countries in the world that uses Imperial is the United States and Uganda. Everybody else uses metric. So anyway, I found them. They work great. No problems, you know. I don't care if they're silver or black. You know, I don't care if they match or not, as long as they hold up my frame. So now, speaking of holding up, I'm putting the fourth leg in, and the weight of it should be able to hold it in place while I get my other bolts and stick them in there. I didn't dip it, so I'm dipping it now. Now it's dipped. And Loctite. So Anyway, so we're almost complete with the bottom part. We're going to put these bolts in, line them up, and get my electric screwdriver, which should make the job go a lot quicker, and zip one in, tight enough. Not super tight, but tight enough to hold it in place. Get the second bolt, put that in, and again. And the next thing we're going to do is make sure this is okay. And give a little tiny tap to make sure it's like, you know, all even. And flip this over. Okay. So guess what now? We're going to do the same thing except on the opposite side. So I'm putting all my little pieces so I know where they belong on the sides of them. So I'm not going to confuse anything. So it makes my life a little easier. And from there, we're going to put the first one on with the first bolt. I'm going to do it closer to you so you can see better. So I'm going to start flipping it around and turning it so you have a better view. All right, so this is the wrong screwdriver. So I'm going to use my electric drill for this one. Electric screwdriver, I keep calling it a drill. So that goes in. Okay, so I get another bolt. I'm going to show you in close up here. You can see that it's pretty not straight yet because you can see that extrusion sticking up. So we're going to have to do some adjustments later on. Do a couple of adjustments to make sure everything is totally bent straight. All right, so we're going to screw this in. That's pretty easy now because everything's not, you know, not flapping around anymore. And then we're going to do the same thing again on the other corner, laying it across onto the other rod. Remember, blind joint always up, the bigger hole on that side so you can fit your screws in. I guess you guys by this point know the drill already. You know, wash, rinse, and repeat until you get all the four corners. So I guess we're going to jump into now to making sure everything's aligned. All right, so here's where you kind of kick the tires, make sure everything's flat, you know, check every corner, every angle, every surface. Do it three times just to make sure. You're probably going to have some spots that's going to feel like impossible. If you keep playing with it, you'll probably get it close to better. Sometimes, you know, you want to tap an edge that seems to be sticking out just a little bit, see? Like that, a little tiny tap, and it twists that rod around. See, I felt a little joint right there tapping, so I'm knocking that in, and that should be a little better. Now I'm going to check for squareness, and I do this on all the corners, every angle, every place possible. And once that's done, I'm going to do one more thing, and that is, ready for this? Ha! If you're going to be square, you might as well get the corner joints over here and make it super square. But wait, that's not all. Let me show you what else I got over here. And we have corner plates. These will make the sides flat. So between the corner joints and the corner plates, everything's gonna be super, super squared up. So you're gonna put these screws on. I'm only gonna put two per side. The middle one in the corner is for if you have a tapped extrusion. And you don't need very long screws. You just need little kind of short screws. I'm going to show you. You put it through like that. And then you're going to have a little mushroom top. See, like this. And then just give it about like one turn or half a turn, and that's it. That should stay in place. And that's it. That's pretty easy. So let me do the rest of these over here. And we'll continue on our way to the next step. So you basically turn these up to align this way, straight, sideways, and then drop it right in. And when you turn the screw driver, it locks and twists into place. And then the plate, the same thing. You kind of want to like shore it up and then get something flat. And I'm going to use my machinist square, butt it right up against it and make sure that's okay. And then I'm going to hold it in place with my thumb. Make it a little tighter so it can stay, and then I'll keep doing that until I get it totally straight. So that's what it looks like. Now, this extrusion over here has some jagged edges. It wasn't cut really good. So I need to file some of these like sharp edges and make it a little smoother, a little flatter, because it wasn't a great cut. So by doing that, the plates will fit better. And now another thing too is if you're gonna be using the corner joints and the side plates, that's gonna take 128 screws and nuts. So just remember the golden rule: when you think you have enough screws and nuts, buy some more, because you don't. You're gonna lose them, they're gonna fall on the floor, you're gonna be short. So don't get caught with your pants down. Always have spares. Okay, so look, the plate looks perfect now. If it's flat, it's not gonna stick out. This is what it looks like. I don't have enough screws and bolts to do all the corners right now, so I'm gonna wait to do the rest, but this is what it looks like for now. So this frame is super stiff and very rigid, so I don't think it's gonna be doing any flexing at all.
You also have to make sure the screws are tight, because if any vibrations, it's gonna appear on your prints. And I just got one of these as a souvenir. How bad could this be?